Clooney is one of the most successful actors in Hollywood today, but what people constantly talk about is his relationships and his lack of marriage. Though I've had a look at his chart. He's a Taurus sun, which is, you know, which is an interesting interesting sign. It's a very stubborn sign. And I think George is someone who really wants things to be the way he wants them. So for him to let somebody into his life, it's very difficult for him to change his ways. So within his chart, Sun in Taurus, Mercury in Taurus, Mars in Leo, the sign of acting and performing, so he knows how to do that very well. Moon in Capricorn with Saturn.
Oh, ouch.
Which is, you know, it's not a great place for your moon to be. So I think a lot of his, you know, he has a few dark moments, and I think a lot of his inability to form long-standing relationships up until this point have been that he's, you know, he's a little bit scared of things.
I think it sounds like emotionally he would be, definitely. The rest of it probably works quite well with Mars.
Exactly. I mean, he's very successful. I mean, Syriana, Men Who Stare at Goats, those kind of really quirky movies that he's in, along with the big Ocean's 11 and those blockbusters that he does, he can kind of do anything. And he's also a director. So Mars in Leo is someone who wants to be in charge, and people line up behind them and follow their vision is.
I think he's got strong vision. I think that I mean, really, if you look at his chart, and I'm not the astrologer in the room, but it's so obvious to me that his relationships are debilitated.
Though
the choice of his partners seems to have changed and reaffirmed that over time too. His latest partner, particularly.
Stacey Keibler. Yeah. Yes. Well, Stacey's an interesting one because she's about 19 years younger than him.
Is there really that much gap?
It's a huge gap. Mm. And for all the astrologers out there, they've gone, oh, 19 years, that's the nodes of the moon. So they've got their axis of destiny in the same spot, which is kind of saying to me that this is a really karmic, fated relationship for George. And she is very different. She's Libran, so that's why she's just beautiful and very, you know, you don't see that. But when she gets into the ring, or when she wants to be, she's, you know, she's tough. He's been married once before. Interestingly, he is coming into another cycle where that could happen again. Mm-hmm. What do you think? What do the cards say, Gav?
Let's come to
the card. What everyone wants to know, is he going to get married again? I don't know why it's such a thing with him, but it's...
Well, he's the penultimate bachelor, isn't he?
Yes, he's sort of the Cary Grant of his era.
Yeah.
And also with his chart... The eclipse before his birth was exactly on his descendant, which rules marriage.
Wow.
So it's kind of one of those zones that he really doesn't want to go there if he doesn't have to. And I don't blame him for being a little bit gun-shy.
Well, and he's in doubt, I would say, too, about the whole thing, which doesn't surprise me that I pull that card out.
Yes.
And will probably continue to be.
Yeah. It's like it's a real sore point in his life. It's one of those things that he's so successful everywhere else, but nobody has a perfect life.
No.
Everybody's got issues, and this is the one issue for him that is not so easy.
It comes from... Actually, I wonder in his past if he's had some injustice towards him within marriage. So someone has been...
In a past life.
Either in a past life or in a current life, and not been completely faithful.
Okay.
Would be where that's suggesting that's coming from, too.
Yeah.
I should say that.
With all that, I think with all that Earth, so the Taurus and the Capricorn, that need for someone to be faithful would be very, very strong. And he's not Mr. Play Around kind of guy.
No.
Once he's in it, he's in.
Yeah. He needs to find the pleasure in marriage. I think he probably sees it as something that is a bit of a ball and chain. And I mean, he's built a whole personality about being, you know, a bachelor in some ways too.
So I know.
The ultimate catch.
I'm almost feeling at the moment that I can't breathe. It's like he feels like he gets into the married side of a relationship and he can't breathe.
Yeah.
And it becomes suffocating in some way. So he needs that freedom.
Yeah, definitely. And I think there's going to have to be a death of something within him. This is the death and rebirth card. This will be probably bachelorhood, I imagine. He has to give it up, which he's built so much character on. So that would be a big ask.
It would be, and hearts would be broken around the world. So maybe it's a good thing that he doesn't.